Hello everyone, welcome to AmCode, and in this lecture we're going to see what is a OLAP in data warehousing and what are the significance. So in the last lecture we have seen the basic architecture of a data warehouse. So in this lecture we will be continuing with our next topic, which is OLAP, which is an acronym for Online Analytical Processing Server. So what it actually means, that we're going to discuss in this video. So this OLAP is based on the multi-dimensional data model. So it allows managers or the data analyst to get an insight of the information for fast and consistent, as well as the interactive access to the information. So the basic task of a business analyst is to have an insight of what is going on in the organization and help them analyze the process, which will be beneficial for the growth of the business. So this lecture will cover the different types of OLAPs, operation on OLAP, and the differences between the OLAP and the statistical databases and the OLTP. So there are mainly four types of OLAP servers which are given here. First one is relational OLAP, next one is multidimensional OLAP, hybrid OLAP, and a specialized SQL servers. So we are going to discuss each type one by one in brief. So the first one is relational OLAP. So the relational OLAP, or also we can say it as a ROLAP, servers which are placed between relational backend servers and the client frontend tools to manage the data which is present in the warehouse. So the ROLAP uses the relational or extended relational DBMS, which is a database management system. So it includes these following tasks. So the first one is implementation of aggregation navigation logic. The next one is optimization for each DBMS, and the last one is additional tools and services. So these following points are included in the ROLAP. Our next type of OLAP is a multidimensional OLAP. So the MOLAP uses array-based multidimensional storage engine for the multidimensional views of a data. So what are multidimensional data? You are already aware with this concept. So with multidimensional data stores, the storage utilization may be low if the data set is sparse. So therefore, many MOLAP servers uses a two level of data storage representation to handle the dense and sparse data sets. This was all about multidimensional OLAP. Our third type of OLAP is hybrid OLAP. So what do you mean by hybrid OLAP? So as the name suggests, it is a combination of both ROLAP and MOLAP that we have discussed earlier. So it offers the highest scalability of a ROLAP and the faster computation of a MOLAP. As you are already aware that the multidimensional OLAP uses the two levels of data storage to handle the dense and sparse data sets. So definitely it has the faster computation. So this hybrid OLAP combines higher scalability of a ROLAP and the faster computation of MOLAP. ROLAP servers allows to store the huge amount of data of a detailed information. So the aggregation are stored separately in the MOLAP store. And now our last type of OLAP is a specialized SQL servers. So what is that actually? So the specialized SQL servers provides the advanced query language and the query processing support for the SQL queries over the star and snowflake schema. So this was all about the different types of OLAPs in detail. So our next topic is OLAP operation. These are the operations which are present in the online analytical processing server. So the first one is rollup, then drill down, slice and dice, and pivot. So we'll discuss each operation in detail with some simple example. So the rollup performs aggregation on a data cube by two ways. So these are the following two ways which we can perform the rollup on our data. So the first one is by climbing up a concept hierarchy for a dimension. So here you can see in this data cube, there are three dimensions mainly. The first one is items, second one is time, which is presented in quarters, and the locations. So among these three dimensions, climb up a concept hierarchy, then we will call it as a rollup. And the second one is by dimension reduction. So these are the two ways how we can perform the rollup operation on our data. So as you can see in this example, here the rollup operation is performed by climbing up a concept hierarchy for the dimension location. So here we have rollup on the locations. So here you can see the cities we have roll up by climbing up a hierarchy. We have roll up the locations from cities to the countries, as you can see in this example. So by rolling up, the data is aggregated by ascending the location hierarchy from the level of city to the level of countries. So the drill down operation is the exact opposite of a roll up operation. So it is performed by these following two ways. First one is by stepping down a concept hierarchy for a dimension, and the second one is by introducing a new dimension. So here we will take the same example. So in this example, we have drilled down on the time dimension. So as you can see, firstly, it was present in the quarterly manner. So these are the four quarters for a time dimension. Whenever we have performed the drill down operation, it has been converted into the monthly manner. So this operation is known as a drill down operation. So in this case, the time dimension is descended from the level of quarter to the level of month, as you can see. Our next operation is slice operation. Slice operation selects one particular dimension from the data cube and provides the new subcube. So let's consider in this example, we'll help you understand how the slice operation works. Here we have sliced down the time dimension. So here the slice is performed for the dimension time using the criteria time. So here we have used the criteria for Q1 quarter. So it will form a new subcube by selecting one or more dimension. So here we have used the dimension time, and here we have used the criteria for the Q1 quarter. As you can see in this new subcube, our next operation is dice operation. So the dice operation selects two or more dimensions from the given cube and provides the new subcube. Consider this figure to help you understand how the dice operation works. So here in this example, we have used the data cube, which has the three dimensions: the items, time, which is in quarterly manner, and the locations. And this is the result subcube. We have taken the two locations, two time quarters, which is Q1 and Q2, and the two items from this primary data cube, and we have converted it into a new subcube, as you can see in this figure. So the last but not least, pivot operation. So the pivot operation is also known as a rotation. So it rotates the data in a view in order to provide an alternative representation of the data. So let's consider this example where we have two dimensions, namely locations and the item types. So if you want the different representation of this two-dimensional table, we have given the location item vertically and the item types horizontally. But if we need alternate representation of this data, we can give the item types in the vertical manner and the location types in the horizontal manner. So we have just rotated the data axis to provide us the required presentation of the data. So this was very simple operation of a OLAP. So I hope you understood what is a online analytical processing server and what are the different types of OLAP in details. And also we have discussed what are the different OLAP operations in brief with some simple, easy to understand examples. So if you like this video, please subscribe to AmCode and don't forget to ring the notification bell to get the latest updates. Thanks for watching.